Welcome to SPSC online classes and I am your math teacher and students. Now we are going to solve math assignment number 10 of grade 5. Okay beta, as we are doing chapter number 2 and we have to learn many topic in this chapter. So beta, today we will do word problem. So the new topic is word problem. So beta, first open your book and come on to page number 45. Page 45. Page 45. Fine. Okay. Page 45. First, we will do examples and then we will solve the questions. Okay. Okay. Now the first question. First example is what they are saying. At a fun fair, there were 5 times as many children as adults. It means, let's suppose our adult is 2, then what will be the strength of children when we will add 2, 5 times. Fine. So there were twice as many boys. Twice means double, 2 times many boys as adults. And there were 182 more girls than adults. So we don't know about the adult strength. So let's suppose the adult strength is equal to 1 unit. Adults have just 1 unit. The strength of adult is just 1 unit. Then boys, they are saying that boys are twice of adults. It means boys have 2 units. Then girls, they are saying that girls, and there were 182 more girls than adults. 182 more than girls as adults. So adult has 1 unit. It means 1 unit more than 182. So it's mean we will add 3, 2 blocks block, and the difference between from this point to this point is equal to 182, where they are saying they're 182 more than adults. Yes. So no, we can make the statement here from here. So as we know that 2 units, leave the 1 unit, because they are saying that more than 182 more than as compared to adults. So adult have just 1 unit, leave the 1 unit. So the difference between this point to this point is equal to 182. So 2, it's mean this difference is equal to 2 units. So 2 units is equal to 182. Then 1 unit will become what? 1 unit, 182. 2 is multiply here. When 2 will move on the other side, it will divide. So 182 divided by 2, what will be the answer? 182 divided by 2. 2 9s are 18, and then 2 1s are 2. It's mean 91. 1 unit is equal to, the strength of 1 unit is equal to 91. 91. So then 6, how many units are here? They are saying that how many people were there at the fun fair. It means they are asking about the total number of strength. The total number of strength, it means we will add all the numbers. So how many units are here? 1 unit is equal to 91 students. So how many units are here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we multiply with 6 units for the total. 6 units will become 91 multiply 6. So what will be the answer? 91 multiply 6. 91 multiply 6. So 6 ones are 6, 6 nines are 54. It means the total number of pupils at the fun fair is equal to 546. 546. This is the total number of pupils at the fun fair, and this is your final answer. Understood, beta? Okay. Now come on the second example, page 46. Okay, now come on the second example, page 46. Okay, second example. In the second example, they are saying that there was an equal number of boys and the girls in the school hall. After 108 boys left the hall, means leave the hall, fine. The number of girls in the hall become 4 times the number of boys in the hall. So how many pupils were there in the hall at first, means at the start? So beta, at first means girls and boys are equal here. But after, girls are, there are 4 units and boys leave the 108, the number of 108 boys left the hall. It means boys left the 3 units. So 3 units you will write with pencil on the book. So 3 units, they are saying that after 108 boys left the hall, means how many boys left the hall? 108. Then 3 units, 1, 2, 3, 3 units will is equal to how many boys? 108. So 1 unit will become what? So how 108 divided by 3, it means 3 is multiplied here, 3 will divide on the other side. So what will be the answer? You will find here. Fine? According to division. So write down the answer here, and then 8 unit, it means the answer will multiply with 8. And then find out the final solution. Okay? Now it's your task. Complete this question on book with pencil. Now come on the next question. And the next question is, a grocer sold 4,785 orange and 7,090 kg of tomatoes in a year. Orange were sold in bag of free for $5. Means there are how many oranges? 4,785. And he have to make 3 pairs of 3 bag, means 3 orange, 1, 2, 3. So one bag, second bag, third bag, and so on. So it means orange were sold in a bag of 3 for $5. It means each bag, each 3 orange bag, the price, the cost of each orange, 3 bag orange is equal to $5. And every kilogram of tomato was sold for $6. Means 1 kg, the price of 1 kg, the cost of 1 kg tomato. Tomato is equal to $6. So how much did he receive altogether in 1 year? Fine? Okay, how? So they are saying that the 4,785 oranges, and he have to sold 3 oranges in each bag. It's mean how many bags he sold? So first we will find the number of bags. Fine. First we will find the number of bags. So it's mean 4,785 will divide by 3. So when we will divide by 3, as we will obtain 1,595. It's mean he have to sold 1,595 bag of oranges. And as we know that they are asking about the total cost, means how much did he receive altogether in 1 year. So the next one, the grocer sold 1595 bags of three orange. It means the cost of one bag, the cost of one bag is 1 orange bag. You can write the cost of 1 orange bag. Is $5. So then 1595 bag cost of 1595 bags is equal to 1595 multiplied $5. So when we will multiply, you will multiply here 1595 with 5, multiply this. 5 5s are 25, 5 9s are 45, and 2 47, 5 5s are 25, 29, 5 and 2 7. It means 7 9 7 5. You will write with pencil. Understood, beta? On the book. So 7 9 7 5. Okay, now the grocer received how much money? 7975 from the sale of orange. Now the next part, they are saying that and every kilogram of tomato was sold for $6. It means the number of tomatoes are here 7090. Then 7090 multiplied $6 is equal to what? Now it's your task. Write down here. And then grocer receive means this amount from the sale of tomato. The total amount, we will add this amount and this one and then find out the total amount. Now it's your task, complete this question on book. Now come on the next question. And the next question is question number 4. First, turn out the page number 47. Okay, now question 5. Sorry, question 4. Question 4 is 3 similar shirts and 4 similar ties cost $240 altogether. Means same shirts and same ties cost means price $240 altogether. Means the altogether means the total price. Fine. Each shirt cost, each means one shirt cost twice as much as each tie. It means the price of the tie, when we will add the price of the tie two times, it will become the shirt price. Fine. Okay, the each shirt cost twice as much as each tie. What is the total cost of one shirt and one tie? So how we will do this question? That shirt, how many shirts are here? Three same shirts, and they are saying that. So first we will make the three shirts. It means three units. You will represent by the units, fine, because it's easy for us. Three shirts, fine. Okay, and the number of ties. How many number of ties I have? Four. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Fine. And now they are saying that each shirt costs twice as much as shirt. So it means twice we will half to double off. So then what will be the total cost of one shirt and one tie? So how many units will become here? Twice mean we will break one unit into two parts. Twice mean two times. When if they are, I have to say that thrice, then we will break the one unit into three parts. So twice mean we will break or we will divide one unit into two parts. So how many units will become 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10? It's mean. The total cost, they are saying that the total cost is $240. In the first line, 3 same shirts and 4 same tie cost $240. It means 10 unit is equal to how many cost? 10 units is equal to $240. Then 1 unit, 1 unit will become how much amount? 10 is multiply here, then 10 will divide on the other side. When we will divide 240 by 10, so what will the answer? 240 divided by 10. 10 2s are 20, 4 and then 0, 10 4s are 40. It's mean 40, 24. $24, one unit is equal to $24. Then 3 units will become how much amount? One unit is equal to 24 and then 3 units. It's been $24 multiply with 3. So dollar, when we will multiply, you will get the amount of 3 units. Then that amount will be the cost of one unit and one tie is equal to this one. Now it's your task. Multiply these two numbers and find out the final answer. Understood, beta? Okay. Now come with the next question. Okay, the next question 5. And in question 5, they are saying that a laptop cost means the price of the laptop is $645. More than a printer means the printer price is, let's suppose, x, then what will be the price of laptop? It will become x plus $645. So we will add the price 645 in the price of printer price, then it will become the laptop cost. Two such laptop and three such lab printers cost dollar. This is the total amount of two laptop and three printer. $2,470. How much does a such laptop cost? Means they are asking about the one laptop cost, one laptop price. So how we can find it now? So look at here, laptop. The cost of laptop means this is the first, let's a laptop cost when a one unit and the more than 645, it's mean we will add the two units. Look at the space of laptop and then cost of other laptop and the total cost of laptop and three printer is equal to 2470. So how many units will become two laptop and three printer? It's mean 2 plus 3 5. It's mean 5 unit is equal to, when we will subtract 5 unit will become $2,470 when we will subtract the multiplication of the extra amount, that is 245 multiply. How many laptops are here? 2. So when we will multiply 245 with 2 and then we will subtract, this will obtain the amount of 5 units. Fine? And how can we get? So in the first step we will multiply with 245 with 2. So 245 multiply with 2. 2 5s are 10. 1 is carry, 2 4s are 8, 9, 2 2s are 4. 490. It's mean $2470 minus $490. $490. This was the amount 645. 6, 45. Now multiply with 2. 2 5s are 10. 2 4s are 8, 9. 2 6 are 12. Win dollar $1,290. Now subtract the amount. $2,470 minus $1,290. So $0. Can we subtract 9 from 7? No, we will carry from here. So it will become 3, 1, 7, 17. 17 minus 9, 8. Then 3 minus 2, 1. And 2 minus 1, 1. So it means $1,180. 5 units have $1,180. Fine? Okay, then 1 unit will become how much dollar? So 5 is multiplied with here. So 180 divided by 5. 5 will divide on the other side. Will come. So divide here and find out the answer. And then it's your task. And now the cost of one laptop is equal to 1 unit price. It's me. You will find the final solution and then you will write the final solution here. Then plus $645. And then find out the total amount that was the such laptop cost price. Understood, beta? Okay, now complete this other question on book. Now come on the last question. Okay, now come on the last question, and last question is city and cat have 3049 beads altogether, and Priya and city have 3647 beads in all. Priya has 3 times as many beads as cat. How many beads do the 3 girls have in total? So city and Priya have all together means 3647. The total beads city and Priya have 3645. Then it means then they are saying there in the next statement Priya and city have fine. City have 3647. So 47 beads in all Priya and 3 times as many beads as cat. So 2 units, look at this diagram, and then 2 units will become when we will subtract 3049 from 3647, then you will get 4598. Then 1 unit will become 598 divided by 2. 2 will divide here. Then find out the answer. Then 4 unit will become what? Write down this amount here and then multiply with 4. Then find out the answer here. Kate and Priya have, write on this solution here, and that will be the total beads with Kate and Priya. No, 3,449 minus which amount is equal to the final solution? No, it's your task. This one is so easy. Complete this question with pencil here. Fine? Okay. Now turn the page and come on the page number 49 and question number 7. Example number 7 is me. Okay, the example number 7 is Farhan and Junhao had the same number of points in the game. After Farhan got, okay, now question number 7. Farhan and Arjuna had the same number of points in the game. After Farhan got another 470 points and Junhao got another 50 points, Farhan had 3 times as many points as Junhao. Okay, beta. Now question number 7. Question number 7 is that they are saying there are two number of peoples and they are Farhan got 470 points and the other one is got 50 points and then the first one is three times as many points as the other one. So how many points did each of them have at first, means starting? So two units, then the Farhan have this one is the Janahoy is the 50 more, means that one unit Janahoy have the one unit, then Farhan have how many units? Three units, because they are saying that three times as many points as Janahoy. So three units. So the one unit three times means the total difference between from this point to this point, it will become 470. So two units is equal to 470 minus the first we will subtract the 50 because they are saying they got another 50 points. Fine. So we will subtract the 50 and then you will obtain the 420. So write on here 420 when we will subtract 50 from 470. Then one unit will become 420 divided by 2. 2 will divide, multiply here, 2 will divide on the other side. Then find out the answer. And then in the next step, what we will do here? Yes, they are saying that how many points did each of them have at first? No, it's your task. Complete this question on book. Fine. Okay. And the last question, there were 40 cows and the children. There were 40 cows and the chicken are together on the farm. Okay. Now question 8. There are 40 cow and chicken are together on a farm. The total number of legs is 108. How many cows are there? So beta, we don't know about the total number of chicken, that how many chickens are here, how many cows are here. So is the probability, there are the some probability that the cow, let's suppose the number of animals are 20, the number of legs, number of animals 20, then number of legs will be 20 multiply 4, as animals means a cow. Here we are talking about the cow. Fine. So then cow have how many legs? 4 legs. It's mean we will multiply with 4, it will become 80. And chicken, then number of animals, let's suppose chicken are 20. They are saying that the total 40, there are 40 cow and chickens. So let, there are some probabilities. If 20 cows are here, then 40, 20 cows, then cow have 4 legs, multiply with 4, it will become 80. 80. Fine. 80 legs of cow. Then chicken cow, chicken legs have, chicken have how many legs? Then let's suppose there are 20 chicken and chicken have 2 legs, then we will multiply with 2, it will become 40. And when we will add 40 plus 80, it will become 120. Fine. And they are saying 108. The total number of legs is 108. So we will find the 108 amount from here. Okay, now 20 and the next, let the number of cow is 15, then 15 multiply with 4 cow, here we are talking about the cow, 4 5s are 20, 4 60, it will become 60 leg of cow. And then when a cow is 15, then number of chicken will maybe 25 multiply with 2, it will become 50, 50 plus 60, then it will become 110. And the next third probability is if there are 14 chicken, sorry cow, then 14 cow have 4 legs, multiply with 4, 4 4s are 16, 4 1s are 4 and 5, 56. And then 14 are cows, then how many chicken were there? So 26 multiply with 2, 2 6 are 12, 2 2s are 4 and 5. So when we will add 6 plus 2, 8, 5 5, 108. So 108 is obtained, as they are saying the total number of legs is 108. It means in this for this number, how many cows are there? How many cows are there? 14. 14 cows are there. Understood, beta? Okay. Now, come on the practice question. Practice question, question 1. Come on the practice, page number 50. Page 50, question 1. There are 24 bags of cements and 2,300 bricks at a construction site. The mass of the each bag is 2 kg. Means mass means weight. The weight of each brick is 2 kg and the mass of each bag of cement is 30 kg. What is the total mass of the cement at the construction site? Mass of the they are asking about the total weight of cement at the construction site. Fine. Okay, now hope we can solve this question. So beta, look at the board. First, the total number of bags of cement. Practice question. Question 1. First, write down the total number of bag of cement. Of cements. Cement. How many bags are here? 24. And the mass of each bag of cement is equal to 30 kg. Fine. So then the total mass of 24 bag, you can write here the mass of 24 bag. Mass of 24 bags of cement. The mass of each bag means one bag is 30 kg. Then 24 bag mass, it means we will multiply. Then when they are asking about more than one, then we will multiply. Fine. So 30 kg multiply with 24. So what will be the answer? 30 multiply 24. 4 multiply with 0. Any number will multiply with 0. The answer is 0. 4 threes are 12. Multiply 2 multiply 0, 0. 2 2 threes are 6. 0, 2 and 7. It means 720. Total mass 720 kg. Mass of 24 bag of cement. Fine. Okay. Now find out the mass of total mass of bricks. So as they are saying that there are how many bricks are here? 2300 and mass of each brace is equal to 2 kg. Then mass of 2300 brace more than 1, it means we will multiply. 2 kg multiply 2300. So what will be the answer? 2 0 2 0 2 3 is 6 2 4 is 2 2 is 4 kg. This means mass of 2300 bricks is equal to this one. Okay, now the mass of 24 bags is this one and the mass of 2300 bricks is this one. No, you can find the total mass of bricks and cement. So add these two numbers and find out the total mass. Now it's your task. Complete this question. Fine. Find out the total mass. Okay. Understood, beta? Okay, now after the question number 1, question 2 and 3 are not included in your assignment. Question 4 is included. And question 4, look at the question 4. The total cost of 5 computer and 3 printer is $7100. And the total cost of 4 such computer and 3 such printer is this one. Find the cost of the printer, one printer. So as we already done this type of the example in the previous pages, so beta, it's your task. You will do this question yourself. Understood, beta? Okay, now come on the question number 6. Question 5 and 7 also not included in your assignment. So there are just 3 questions are included, 1, 4 and 6. So come on the question 6. Question 6 is the last question of this assignment. So they are saying that Bala is 11 year old and his father is 37 year old. In how many years time will Bala's father be 3 times as old as Bala? So they are asking about the number of year, in which year? So look at the board, how we will did the first question, as we are doing page number 51 and the question number 6. Okay, according to statement, as they are saying that the father age will become, first write on the father age. Father age is 37 year old, and then Bala's age 11 year. And let the difference between, you can say that the number of year, the in which the Bala's father will 3 times as old as Bala. Let the year, that year is equal to x. You can suppose that we don't know about the year, that in which year the Bala's father will 3 times as old as it. So let's suppose the that year is equal to x, then the father age, will the x, add the x into the father age, and then x will also add in the Bala age. And as they are saying that the Bala's father be 3 times as old as Bala. For Bala's father is 3 times, it means when we will multiply with 3 in the age of Bala, it will become the father age. Understood? According to statement, this is in your equation. Now solve this equation. 37 plus x, 3 is multiplied with 11 and x both. When we will open the bracket, 3 will multiply with 11 and x both. 3 11s are 31 plus 3 multiply x, 3x. Now arrange the variables on one side and the constant on the other side. Okay, now 37 minus 33 will come on the left side, and 3x and minus x. 37 minus 33, 4. 3x minus x, 2x. Okay, you can write on the variable value on the left side and constant value on the right side, and then find out the x. Leave the x here, and 2 is multiply with x, so when 2 will come on the other side, it will divide. So 4 divided by 2. It's mean in two years, what will be the father age and Bala age? You will write just Bala age and the father age in 2 years. Now think about it and solve this question. Fine, it's your task. Okay.